Hello viewers, I am Dr. R.V. Chittuguppi from Classic IAS and KAS Study Circle, Dharwad. Once again, I am back with the history sessions. So in my previous videos, we have discussed different aspects of history which are important from the competitive examination point of view. So today we will be choosing another subject where questions can be related. So here today topic is important places connected to Gandhiji in India. So one of the here well known figure of our national movement, Mahatma Gandhiji, popularly called by the people as the Bapu. So he is also referred as the father of the nation. So this word was first time used by the great revolutionary Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So like this, I'll be giving you the hints where you can take here mainly here the points so that it is useful for you for your competitive examination. So the question may come like who called Gandhiji as the here mainly here father of the nation. So it was Subhash Chandra Bose who called him as the father of the nation. So connected to Gandhiji, I will be taking some important places and I will be speaking about the role of Gandhiji in that particularly the period. So Gandhiji, as you know that here, was born in 1869 October 2nd at Porbandar. This is the place where we have got the birthplace of Mahatma Gandhiji. This is in Porbandar called as Kirti Mandir. Today it is known as Kirti Mandir. And in our mainly mythology, Pura here mainly Porbandar was referred as Sudamapura. In Mahabharata, we come across the reference as Sudamapura. So that was his mainly the birthplace what we have got. 1869, here it is in Gujarat. Now, this date has to be remembered, that is October 2nd. So this is the birth here anniversary of Mahatma Gandhiji, but not forgetting here another personality was also born on the same day, October 2nd, and that is Lal Bahadur Shastri. So usually Lal Bahadur Shastri and Mahatma Gandhiji together, the birth anniversary is celebrated. Lal Bahadur Shastri went on to become the second Prime Minister of India after Jawaharlal Nehru. So his birth anniversary is also on here October 2nd. So these are connected aspects to that October 2nd. And October 2nd, today UNO has declared this as the World Non-Violence Day. Today we call it as the World Non-Violence Day, the birth anniversary of Gandhi. And the mainly why this word has been coined non-violence day, because Gandhiji was the great promoter of non-violence concept. He is called as the prophet of the here non-violence. So that is why here to mark his mainly this strategy, this policy here, the UNO has declared it as the here non-violence day. So this is here what we have got mainly. Gandhiji, after completing his education in law degree, he had his education in law degree, and later connected to a case here, he had to go to South Africa. He went to South Africa connected to the case of mainly here the merchant Abdullah. So there from 1893 to 1915, Gandhiji stayed in South Africa, where it is said that he invented his weapon Satyagraha in South Africa. And that was where he mainly started the struggle for apartheid, that is against the racial discrimination policy of the mainly the whites. That is apartheid was started, and later as you know that this was continued even by Nelson Mandela. So Nelson Mandela is popularly called as the Gandhi of South Africa. So that is, he spent more than 50, here 20 years, 20 to 22 years in South Africa. And in 1915, he returned back. 1915, he returned back. So before his return from South Africa, he had been to London. And as you know that the period here, 1915 was the period of the First World War. 1914 to 1918, the First World War was going on. So at that juncture, he went to England, and where Gandhiji established an ambulance unit to treat the wounded soldiers. So this mainly the attitude of Gandhi. This mainly the reaction of Gandhi towards here mainly the soldiers, and his kind-heartedness, his humanitarian approach here made the British government to honor him with the title Kaiser A Hind, that is Emperor of India. Gandhiji received the title as Kaiser A Hind here from the British government. So that was the incident when he was returning back, and it was on January 9th 1915 he returned back. And this day here is celebrated in India as the NRI day. We celebrate it as the NRI day, the coming of Gandhi back to here India, 1915. Coming to India, he established the Sabarmati Ashram at Ahmedabad in Gujarat. So he founded, this is the mainly what we have the picture of here, the Sabarmati Ashram founded by here Mahatma Gandhiji. So this ashram is located on the banks of river Sabarmati, hence the name comes as Sabarmati Ashram. 1915 it was established here, and it is from this ashram he undertook his social reformation activities, and even the early here mainly the national movement was from this particularly the place, that is Sabarmati Ashram. 1915 it was established. So after coming back to India, this mainly the ashram was established. But not forgetting, when he was in South Africa, he had already established two ashrams which are called as Tolstoy Farm and Phoenix Farm, which were established in here South Africa. But in India here, the ashram he founded was the Sabarmati Ashram. And later we find Gandhiji, he continued his law practice from 1915 to 1917. And 1917, one of the historic year in the life of Gandhi, we can say. That is mainly taking the cause of indigo farmers at Champaran, he launched the peasant movement, the first satyagraha organized by Gandhiji after he returned back from South Africa. That was the Champaran movement. It is a peasant movement. 1917 it was organized. And earlier also there were peasant movements, like in 1859 we had in Bengal the indigo peasant movement was there. Likewise later we have got the Deccan peasant movement here, which was in 1875 to 79. So earlier also the peasant movements have taken place. So but the grievances of the peasants were never overcome. They were never solved. They were neglected section of the society. They were facing lot of problems. They were here mainly poverty ridden. So hence Gandhiji here mainly took up the cause of the farmers. And one of the local leader, Rajkumar Shukla, invited Gandhiji to come to Champaran and see the here mainly the condition of the peasants. So after seeing this, Gandhiji launched that here Champaran movement. It was against the abolition of the Teen Kanti system, which was followed in Champaran. Champaran comes in Bihar. So there we find here against the Teen Kanti system, this satyagraha was launched 1917. Very recently some 2 to 3 years back, 2017-18, the centenary year of Champaran Satyagraha was celebrated. And this was considered to be the first successful peasant movement in India. Gandhiji had the success and Teen Kanti system was abolished in Champaran. And that was a great success of Gandhiji. So this is in the first Satyagraha itself, Gandhiji was successful. And he won lot of here mainly appreciation for this, particularly from the masses. The masses here appreciated Gandhi for the success there. This is mainly the first, mainly what we have got. So later Gandhiji in 1918, he undertook the Ahmedabad mill workers movement, where it was the reason was for the hike of the salaries of the workers. It was a here workers movement, and it is in that Ahmedabad mill workers movement, which was led in 1918 by Gandhi, where he undertook the first fast Satyagraha. Fast Satyagraha was at Ahmedabad mill workers movement 1918. Later there was another peasant movement which he led in 1918, the Khaira movement or Kheda movement, which is in Gujarat. That is again a peasant movement for the abolition of the taxes and the here famine reliefs. So these were all successful. All the three were successful. Now why this has to be understood from your examination point of view is that why Gandhi was later given in 1920 the leadership of the Indian National Movement. Because all these three successes and the success he had in South Africa. So that showed here mainly here the people began to believe in his strategies, began to believe in his mainly policies. So here Gandhiji's policy here mainly brought that faith among the people, particularly the common people. So hence here the Congress thought that he would be the right person to lead the movement. And 1920 he was given that the leadership, and 1920 he launched the non-cooperation movement, 1922-22. So that was the first movement he launched in the national struggle of India, the non-cooperation movement 1922-22. But with one of the tragic incident or the violent incident which took place at Chauri Chaura in Uttar Pradesh. Here the violent incident here which took place on February 5th 1922. Here disheartened Gandhi, and he immediately had to stop that non-cooperation movement. But later, Gandhiji's ideas were so deep-rooted among the here Indians that they never here deviated from that. Many supported Gandhi's views. So later we find it was in 1924, the annual Congress session was held at Belgaum in Karnataka. It was held at Belgaum 1924, for which on the request of the Congress members and the people, we find Gandhiji became the president of that. So Gandhiji was the president of this here the session. So this is what we are seeing, Gandhiji coming to the here the Congress here mainly the session 1924, which was held at Belgaum. He is coming here mainly towards the stage. And he is addressing the people who had assembled there. So these are mainly the some of the very incidents which are to be remembered. So if you have the visual look, you will remember the incidents very easily. And this is the only Congress session which was presided by Gandhi. So here it has brought a great honors to the state of Karnataka that it had organized a Congress session here where the father of the nation was the president. And this session here was the only session which was held in Karnataka in the pre-independent period. So after independence here the other sessions of the Congress were held, but in pre-independent India the Congress sessions, this is the first here mainly the session there. So after that here we find Gandhiji was involved here in the social problems of India. Mainly here his social problems were the removal of the untouchability. So he was involved in the removal of the untouchability. And he edited the paper called as Harijan in English. And also we find here he here gave into here mainly the attention towards the problems of the peasants, workers. So this mainly the thing he earned him a lot of here mainly the popularity among the masses. In the history of Indian national movement, only one person is called as the mass leader, and it was Gandhiji. Why he was called as the mass leader? These are the examples to show his popularity, how he became popular among the people. So this is mainly what we have got. After non-cooperation, he had involved in the here eradication of the social problems of India. But once again in 1930 there was re-entry of Gandhi in the national movement. After that historic session of 1929, where the president was Jawaharlal Nehru, who declared the Purna Swaraj as the goal of the Congress. So we have here, on the request of all the Congress people, here Gandhiji once again took the leadership, and this time he launched the civil disobedience movement. The civil disobedience movement was launched in 1930 by Gandhi, and this involved the mainly breaking violation of the laws which were burdened to Indians. If the Indians feel that the laws are here a burden to them, here Gandhi said that violate them. Gandhi here mainly said to violate that, but never here adopt the violent means. It should be peaceful protest, which was called as Hartal, or here mainly adopt the Ahimsa principle, but never go for the violence, do not take the arms. So this policy has to be followed here in this the Satyagraha. So civil disobedience movement, when people disobey the laws, they should not lose their patience. Here they should be here very temperament, and they should follow the non-violence principle. Gandhi was very clear on these aspects, and Gandhiji decided to launch this civil disobedience movement by breaking the salt law. By breaking the salt law, he decided to launch this here Satyagraha, and the place he decided to break the salt law was Dandi in Gujarat. Dandi in Gujarat was the place where he selected here for the breaking of the salt law. Dandi here mainly is one of the here place near Surat. And Gandhiji on March 12, 1930, he started the Dandi march from his Sabarmati ashram. He was accompanied by here 78 followers accompanied here Gandhiji to here mainly the Dandi Yatra or Dandi March. So you can see that mainly Gandhiji on April 6, 1930, he reached Dandi, and by taking the salt and distributing it to the people, he broke the salt law. So this is a coming of Gandhi here to Dandi here, and you can see the salt pans. Here he is walking beside the salt pans and breaking the salt law there. So April 6, 1930, here the launch of the civil disobedience movement. So which went on for here nearly 4 years up to 1934. So this is the place where Gandhiji broke the salt law and launched the civil disobedience movement. Along with this, forest laws were also here broken, revenue laws were also broken. So we find Gandhiji here in this way commenced the civil disobedience movement. So it was here when the civil disobedience movement was going on, so a lot of incidents took place. So one here to mention some of the incidents was here, that is the three round table conferences were held in London. Gandhi-Irwin here pact was signed 1931. Here Gandhi-Irwin pact was signed, and along with that here we find here the famous Pune here pact was also signed against the declaration of the communal award. So like this, a lot of events took place. So but after 1933, we find Gandhiji here thought that the civil disobedience movement was here declining. And he asked the Congress to immediately stop it. He asked the Congress to stop it, and in 1933, he established an ashram called as Vardha Ashram, or popularly called as Seva Gram Ashram. So it is also known as Seva Gram Ashram or Vardha Ashram. So it is located in Maharashtra. 1933 he established it. So here you can see, this was the place where Gandhiji lived. So that is the word written Bapu Kutia. Bapu Kuti means the place where Gandhiji lived in Sevagram Ashram. So Sevagram Ashram is in Vardha in Maharashtra. So it was at this place here the ashram was established, and we find from this place in 1933 Gandhiji launched the eradication of the untouchability campaign. The eradication here of untouchability campaign was started from this place, that is mainly the Sevagram Ashram. That was in 1933. And later there was one particularly here a conference was held, Vardha Conference it is popularly called, in 1937. A conference was held, and this conference was a landmark in the Indian education system, because it was at this place here Gandhiji propounded his idea of the basic education, so which is popularly known as Vardha Plan. And it is on that here the basic education has been developed in India. That is one of the historic event which has taken place at this mainly the ashram, what we have got the Vardha Ashram. So like this, these are some of the places where we find Gandhiji here is associated. So like this, we have got here another two important places connected again in Maharashtra itself. At Pune we have got the Aga Khan Palace and the Ervada Prison. We have got two important places, Aga Khan Palace and Ervada Prison. So in 1932, when Gandhiji returned back from the here round table conference, second round table conference from London, he was immediately, and he restarted the civil disobedience movement, he was arrested and he was imprisoned in this Ervada prison, which is in Pune. The Ervada prison, this was the place where he was mainly kept. And here later in 1942, when Quit India movement had taken place, again Gandhiji was arrested and he was mainly kept in this mainly the place, that is here Aga Khan Palace. Both are in Pune itself. And Aga Khan Palace, here is the place where also we find here Gandhiji's wife Kasturiba here breathed her last. It is in this palace she has breathed her last. And also even Mahadev Devsai, the secretary of Gandhi, also died at this place itself. So you can still see those two memorials in this Aga Khan Palace, the Kasturiba Memorial and the Mahadev Desai Memorial. You can notice at this mainly the place in Pune these two are located. These are here mainly in 1932 and 42 here where Gandhiji was imprisoned there. So moving to the next slide, here 1942, the mainly launching of Quit India movement from Bombay. From Bombay, the Quit India movement was launched by Gandhiji. That is that the Britishers must leave India. Bharat Chodo Andolan, Chale Jao. So like this, these were mainly the Quit India. So this word Quit India was coined by the then Mumbai governor, Yusuf Meher Ali. Yusuf Meher Ali coined this word Quit India, which was very accepted to Gandhiji accept, and he mainly named the movement as Quit India movement 1942. So that is what we have. It was mainly on August 8th with the call do or die, he started this movement. The movement was started here called as the Quit India movement 1942. almost in our national movement, we can say this was the last movement, because the rest of the things what we see is how we have achieved our independence. 1942 was the Quit India movement what we see. So you can see this is here mainly the Quit India, how it was launched, how the people had amassed in that, mainly the ground from where Gandhiji launched this movement popularly in Bombay. That ground is known as August Kranti Maidan. That is the place where we have from Gandhiji here launching this Quit India movement. And lastly, coming after gaining our independence, 1948 January 30th, here was one of the mourning day in the history of India, where Mahatma Gandhiji was assassinated at Birla House in Delhi. So this is the Birla House where Gandhiji was assassinated here. And this is here where mainly the last prayer was organized by Gandhiji. So it was here during that period here Gandhiji was assassinated. So Birla House, that is located in mainly Delhi. So today, if you visit this place, this has been converted as one of the most important here palace to be visited here to see the life of Gandhi. Right from his childhood days till his death, we have got many photographs. His letters here are collected. We have got the models. So one can see a lot of things on Gandhiji. If anyone wants to get more knowledge on Gandhiji, here one has to visit this, mainly the place where he was assassinated in 1948. It was January 30th, which we call it as the Martyrs Day. And lastly, here it is in Delhi, once again at Rajghat, we have got the Gandhi's Memorial Samadhi. So that is the Father of the Nation Memorial is at Rajghat in Delhi. And as we know that many here dignitaries who visit this place, or on Independence Day, Republic Day, Gandhi Jayanti, so we find that here mainly the people here offer their respects to our Father of Nation. This is the place where we have that the memorial of Gandhi, the Rajghat in Delhi. So these are some of the places connected to Mahatma Gandhiji, and why they are important also we have discussed there. So you can expect certain questions from this here, mainly the topic also. So for the benefit of the students, I had chosen those mainly the 10 places, so that in between I can also fill up certain aspects which can be useful for your examination also. And if you look at, you can have such questions in your mainly the examinations also. So keeping this here, mainly for the preparation, the important places associated with Gandhi in India. So we are going to conclude here, saying that in the next session, we will be coming out with another important topic on history. Thank you.